Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Just in case you forgot, instead of taking that other pot over on the left side of that room, I would like you to go and take the pot that's over here, because that's the pot that we unlocked via, yes, this right here. So that is the major shortcut back up to the top. Now, here we got another note door. And oh boy, does this note door contain something special. Let's just put it that way. I hope you have your Brintilda questions written down and whatnot, and also I hope you have the game pretty well memorized, because, well, oh man, this is something. It really is truly something. I know that's fantastic commentary, but I don't want to spoil it. What could this be? What could this be? Oh! It's a board game game show, of course! Oh, this caused me lots of ire when I first played through the game, because I didn't really have the thing memorized as well as I do now. And that's still a possibility that I'll have difficulties with this stinker now. But we'll see, I guess. Alright. that plushie looks kinda tempting to get. This game is so ridiculous, I love it. So, as you can tell by the board, there's a bunch of spaces, and they all have different stuff. And you don't really want to go through a lot of those skull spaces, let's put it that way, because those are one-hit kill spaces if you should fail the challenges on them. So yes, so it begins, but first actually, yeah, I'm gonna get that set up for the future, there we go, and away we go. So this space, we're gonna get a little description as we touch a new space. It's a little question about the game when we go on this space. Let's see what we got. Tower in which they hide on Mumbo's Mountain. What's inside? It's termites. Yes. Now, if you get it correct, they'll boo you, but that is okay. The idea is to try and get through this without dying, because if you die, you're going to have to start all the way back from the beginning. So, visual challenger on here. And by the way, if you should fail any of these, other than the skulls, you'll actually take one honeycomb of damage, so it definitely helps to have full health here. Yes, yes. Alright, where have we been? That looks like Bubble Gloop Swamp's egg type place thing? Is it? Yes! Woo! And yeah, as you can tell, you don't have much time to answer those too, so your cheat sheet for grunty questions might not help all that much, and I don't have anything written down as a result of that myself, but they might help in terms of your memorization. These blank spaces, I recommend leaving the honeycombs just in case you need them. I think I'm gonna take this route. This has got a new space. So, this is the Brintilda questions here, basically. A cuddle and a fight. Would I take the bed at night? It was a... it was a scary teddy bear, right? Was it? Yes. Yes. Now, why would she have these questions in the game show if she didn't expect me to know the question? Well, I guess she could be cheating it, but, well, whatever. But thanks to Brintilda, we should know all the answers. We pay... blue eggs, right? 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 Yeah, because we shoot them in the statue things. Time challenges. These are a thing. Yes. Because, well, these are the same mini games we've played before, except much harder. Because of a tighter time limit and just harder stuff. So let's see if we can pull this off. Oh, okay, we got this one. This isn't a big deal at all. Well, I guess I can show this now, huh? Behold! The Wonder Wing! And yeah, otherwise you'd have to do this without the... I mean, you know, you'd have to do this with the rat-a-tat wraps and voila! Can be done in 8 seconds if you use the Wonder Wing. I think... Like you can take a look around the board here, going in the first-person view and whatnot, including seeing Grunty as well as the... Well, kind of some of the prizes there, but yeah. Well, there's one of those skull spaces that I don't want, but you're going to have to pass through some of them eventually. But the thing is I'd like to build up some Joker cards along the way, so I'm going to go this way and just see if I see what I can get here. Alright. This is, who is it? Oh, it's Clanker! Who could forget Clanker in one of the most boring levels? Well, it's not that bad of a level, really, but it's definitely one of my least favorite in the game, because of all the slow swimming and whatnot. Captain's Cabin, yes, yes. The bed, wasn't that Feathers? Anchors, was it? Yes, it was, okay. See, this is why you wouldn't have time to look at any sort of cheat sheets, because you only have 10 seconds, yeah. Alright, so let's listen to the music and see if we can figure out where this world it's from. That sounds like Bubble Gloop Swamp. Yes, yes. So... Wait, no, I mean, Clanker's Cavern, excuse me. Why should I think Bubble Gloop? That's not. Anyway, let's plop over here. What would I have for desserts? That would be... wasn't that... Eyeball Ice Cream? Yes. Yes, yes, yes. This is quite the game, I gotta say. He lost his gold. Yes, yes. How could we forget about him? Let's just get that Joker card. What is it? No, we can slow that. We can slow that. Not those. Yeah, those are the things we gotta flat flip up in the engine room of notoriousness. So yeah, if we get a Joker card, we can skip certain spaces, basically. That's why I'm going over to here. That was... Cauldron Crew, right? Oh no, I'm incorrect! And I took damage, aw, poopers. So, I guess I failed to get a Joker card after all, but, well, it was worth the risk anyway, because these spaces are, as I said, one-hit kills, so... Yeah! well... Let's do our best! okay, it's a music. Let's listen. Oh, that's the Wonder Wing. Alright, so I'll be able to pass through this space okay. And we can get all sorts of things on these one-hit kill spaces as well, so... one that just tried Stilt Wing, what? That's the Wonder Wing. Alright, so we're safe, and I might as well grab that as well. Energy that you have found won't stop me making 2D rounds! I was waiting to need to use one of those. I think I'm gonna end up going around this particular segment like counterclockwise and passing through just one of those insta-death spaces. And hopefully I won't have to because there's a Joker card there, so let's do a Grunty fact card here. Lucky Charm, that was a Dragon's Foot, right? Yes. Yes! So let's move on this way. Free ZZ Ziglu. There was four. Because there was three kids and Boggy, right? What? What? Are you what? Okay. I don't understand. Well, yeah, wasn't there three kids plus Boggy and... oh, whatever. Anyway, you gotta retry a space if you should fail on it. With the exception of the Joker card spaces, of course. That was... Leaky, yeah. That's a pretty simple name. Alright, where have we been? We shall see. Isn't that Tip Top inside the turtle in Bubble Gloop Swamp? Yeah, I guess it's just Bubble Gloop Swamp. Woo! I was just getting a little too specific there. Where have I been? Oh, let's see. That looks like one of those toll booth signs at Rusty Bucket Bay. That looks like a number 8. So, yep. Alright. Music challenge. Let's listen closely. Freezy Z Peak! Yeah, I could tell just by the couple of opening riffs, I guess you could say, of the song. No, don't you dare pick Freeze Easy Cove. Oh no, it's Freeze Easy Peak. That's just trick answers. You flow. It was washed with engine oil, wasn't it? No? Oh, poopers. I forgot. Fat Hag Monthly. Sat on the broomstick? No, it was not. I'm just taking damage left and right now. That's why I saved my honeycombs. She likes to sleep... in a comfy dumpster. What? I thought... Just in case. Well, no, actually, I don't need to grab it now, but... I'm just forgetting all this stuff. That was Spider Pancakes. Yes, finally got that one. Alright, I'm gonna go flop back over and get some honeycombs here. There's that one. Oh, wait, yeah, and there's another one right back there. I could actually get another one there if I should get this question right. So let's give it a shot, because why not? giant armored creature was... yeah, a huge metal whale. Wait, what? No? What? I thought... Maybe I'm just thinking something else, I don't know. Leaves are largest in summer. Yes. That's why I mentioned that in the part of the walkthrough, actually, because I knew that this was a question. Well, that was kind of a waste of time overall. Anyway, let's try the Joker's face. Okay, I should be able to get this one. Oh, Rusty Bucket Bay. How could I forget that one? Alright, let's see what we got. Thought they were gonna kind of... Rusty Clockwood, yeah, they were gonna throw in some fake answers. Alright, so I got a Joker card. Now, what do you... Well, I should say two Joker cards. So what's these things for? Yeah, you can use one to skip a question, and that's very, very handy to use, and as usual, one-ups are especially not worth it in the slightest, especially with all those death spaces around them. I mean, seriously, who would dare even bother to do those when, you know, you'd have to restart this sucker from the very beginning? Seriously. that was a bolt. Wasn't it? Yeah, it was a bolt. Yes, yes, yes. To block out the hole, I guess. Time challenge minigame. What do we get? Hopefully it's not the memory one. Okay, it's just the boss boombox. I wonder if I should just do this completely with Wonder Wings now that I got the Wonder Wing upgrade. Although, I will see. I mean, I don't think it's going to be that tight on time or anything like that. But yeah, just kind of destroy him into smaller pieces before... we get the Wonder Wing out, I guess. because the Wonder Ring will really speed things along, but it's not necessary as usual, ah, poopers. Oh, fine, I'll Wonder Wing it up. I'm wasting energy for the actual game. There we go. Just take them all out. That'll do, I guess. Yeah, that's another thing about if you get a boss, it actually burns your energy, but it's not that big of a deal, I guess. Okay, which character has is a voice? That was that hand. I mean, not the hand, the ghost in the Napper, the sleeping ghost. Yes, well, I guess the hand is also a ghost type thing, but yeah. let's see who we got. Where have we been? This is... It looks like the well at, Mad Monster Mansion, I think. Yes, that is correct. Alright. Do I dare? I mean, I already have two cards here to use for other stuff, and I really don't want to go out of the way, so I'm gonna take a risk here and actually do one of these. Okay, it's another picture one, which means I should get it. That is... Oh, actually, I'm not sure what that is. So, uh-oh. That might be the basket inside, Gobi's Valley. I hope... Yes! Alright, I think I'm home free now, because I got two cards for those two death spaces over there. Jinjos are a crafty lot. On Treasure Cove, where are they not? They are not inside a giant treasure chest. Yeah, that was all sorts of other things except for them. There we go. Alright, picture time. We can do this. We've almost got this. That is the kitchen at Rusty Bucket Bay, of course. That's a pretty low-resolution knife, and how the texture of the emulator did that pretty poorly, but okay, we can see what it is anyway. It doesn't matter, as long as we can do so. Alright, time challenge. Oh no! Oh no! Oh, we only get one shot at this one. Okay, I gotta pay very close attention. Okay, I think it was... Oh shoot, I'm getting stuck. This... Then yellow and purple? Please tell me I'm correct! Please tell me I am correct! I am correct! Yes! That one, along with the Grumbly and Yumbly one, you know, the minigame versus Mr. Vile the Crocodile, are my two most worried about games in this actual game to come up, because they're, yeah, you gotta hope your very best. Anyway. Hangs over the side, it holds a box. But what's inside? That was a new hi-fi! It was TNT. Alright, so how do I skip these spaces again? It was B button. Okay, yeah, that's right. Your Joker misses out on a square, accept the test. You did not dare. Oh no, I will not accept those spaces if I can help it. Okay. I should be able to win now. That is true. That was, Massive Bloomers, wasn't it? Yeah, giant underwear. And, I skipped the space. Victory is mine! Woo! I'm surprised I beat this on my first try, actually. Too bad for you, Grunty. Oh yeah, that was fun stuff. Well, looks like the game is beat. The credits you'll endure. A lot of people do hate credits in movies and games because, you know, it takes a while, but games and movies do it better than others. But yep, we beat the game! Woo! Heck yeah! I kind of want that plush myself. I mean, Tootie can walk herself down, I guess. She's safely saved, and you know that washing machine type thing, or maybe it's a self-heating coffee pot or something, I don't know, that's tempting to get as well. You know what, let's just take all the prices, the prizes. At the very least, it can cash them in at eBay or something like that. Yes. So, these are the credits of the game and how they're introduced. Well, kinda. they're just kinda like insulting their own designers, I guess you could say, kinda, sorta, a little bit. It all depends on what names pop up in the credits, I guess, in their middle name abbreviation type thing, I guess you could say. Deputy Keyboard Tapper, really? Oh man, so many games made. I mean, so many parts made in the game by so many people. These credits could go for quite a while, maybe. So, as I usually say, I did not make the game, these awesome people did. I just made the walkthrough to help and entertain people, because that is what I like doing. And yes. I wonder how long these stinkers are going to go anyway, because yeah, I remember the credits being pretty long. I'm not sure I can pull off that much commentary during this time. Okay, I probably can, because I'm known to be a chatterbox. There is the slowed down banjo voice. Yes. I think they're just going through the worlds of all the main characters. And there's not more main characters than there are people who made the game, let's just put it that way. Oh, Mr. Vile, you truly are the most vile of crocodiles, for you destroyed me many times over. And yeah, I was really worried about getting that game in Grunty's Furnace Fun, but it all worked out. Instead, I got the tip-top one. Of course, of all the ones that I had trouble with. And yeah, you really only have enough time to see that tip-top minigame once, so you better get it right. You know, you can't re-talk the tip-top and have him replay the thing all over again and whatnot. So yeah, and hey, wait, how did you get the Jiggy back, Waza? I had the Jiggy. Did I give it back to you or something like that? I don't think I did. Oh, there's the one with nut issues. It doesn't look as replenished as it did before, so I guess it must have dried out again. Why doesn't it just stick its roots in the water right on the side and just suck them up? I don't know, but I mean, it does seem to have some sort of mobility, so I think it just moved the roots down there and plop them in the water, have a nice, cold, refreshing drink. Well, it's probably more like tepid water in the desert, but still, water is water to a plant. It would be uncomfortable for someone, say, like you and me, for me to drink and whatnot. Yes, and that is a really cute bird. And he's got the Jiggy back too. What? Hey, give me that back. Give me that. I need that. Can't progress through the game without those Jiggies. Oh! By the way, whenever you see Noah, it's Nintendo of America. You know, N-O-A, Nintendo of America. Yeah. See, like, some of those could potentially be considered insults, but maybe not, because they agreed to it. They're a fun group of designers. And now since we're into Click Clock Wood here, this has gotta be coming to an end soon. At least, I hope. I hope. There's not too many critters left, even in Click Clock Wood. Are they gonna reshow Gobi? I don't remember if they do. I don't think they do. Because, yeah, I don't think that Gobi was a thing that was officially the introduction of the character in Click Clock Wood. Gotta find him elsewhere. Alright, now here we go. Hurry! Gotta get back home. Kill the carrots! Yes! Aw, yeah. The world is free of all the minions. Party! Whoa! What kind of drink are you referring to, Banjo? Mumbo is grilling out! They're relaxing, they're eating, they're having a good time. The game is over. Oh yeah, Gruntilda is beaten soundly. Well, that is kind of true. Although, well, yeah, the moves only help so much. So it was a team effort. But, yeah, she did get away, didn't she? The game's not over! The game's not over! It's not over! So, this seems like a good time to end off the part. And with that, I'm going to end off this part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part when I continue my trek through the remainder of the game. Black screen transition.